the strategic management of the conference, who provided us that kind of opportunity where we could learn very frankly, we could interact with each other under those very conducive environment. We had a very good discussion in the last all the sessions. The credit goes to the management, of course. And in my personal capacity, I'm grateful particularly that I got this opportunity to come there and to present a paper on business tools for global harmony and flow systems, curriculum, common language for developing relationship. Fundamentally, the basic theme has been in my mind that despite prosperity, all the three main dimensions of human development, that may be the social, political, and economic, the world is getting more and more radicalized, polarized, fragmented, and insolvent. And under these environments, what role the business schools can play, that was basically the theme in which I wanted to look into. Because business and economics, they predominantly drive the human activities. So business schools, in fact, the business graduates, when they come into their practical life, they have more influence on the society in all dimensions, in all the three dimensions which I mentioned earlier, may it be the political part, it's the economic, may it be the social part. This was the objective of the study, in fact. We wanted to comprehend the role of business schools curriculum as common language for integrated organizational functioning, to highlight the problems of developing countries, business schools who intend going for internationalization status, to ascertain linkage between business management and universal peace and harmony based on interpersonal relationships, and to conclude the model for strengthening human relationship based on curriculum as a common language. The abstract, I have given a paper to all of you. You can read the paper. Basically, it was the business school all over the world produced professionals in the categories of job seekers and job providers. In the wide spectrum of the business and job market, we come across either the employers or the employees. Both are educated and groomed in the business schools. If we look at the history of human conflicts leading to wars and culminating at utter devastations, a sensible man would hardly find any plausible reason for that. Mostly these got initiated or egos, lack of communication, language, and gestures. Since 4 to 5 decades before, there has been gradual rise in establishing business schools and producing professionals in millions every year in developing as well as the developed countries. Now, these business schools have different standards of education and grooming for the young minds. Once these graduates join different organizations, they develop co-workship or the relationship where they work together. In today's world, we find business graduates as heads of the multinational firms, national business setups, political parties, bureaucracies, public sector functionaries, and even the state leadership. So mostly the people, they come from the business schools with their business education. They have their comrades working in different countries and different organizations. The point is that if we develop a kind of global curriculum for business schools and internationalize these institutions, we would be producing the graduates who know each other before starting their practical lives. Having common curriculum to a larger extent and achieving a reasonable circulation of students among business schools, we would actually be attaining leadership of common understanding and language. Resultantly, it would help us attaining that global peace and harmony in the diversified world of today. So this was basically the keyword: global curriculum, business growth, sustainable coexistence. That was the focus of the paper. My short presentation that covered these main areas. I would briefly cover these points because we are already late, and I won't like to take much time because you will be late for your dinner as well. So coming on to a very short introduction, as I said earlier, the three dimensions of human interactions include culture, political and economic aspirations, and communication needs have been the fundamental source of connecting these three domains of human activities. Political physical boundaries of states, that were intact are becoming more flexible in view of facilitating means of communication and interstate businesses. For all these activities to succeed, business education is forerunner. Accordingly, the business schools have become more relevant in view of the ever-increasing market demands. Few more points about the introduction, that is inserting the technology which had accelerated the pace of mutual interactions in the business schools. And two more points. So that's where we say that it has become essential to understand the common business language, standards, and networking would enhance relationship in all aspects of human life, thereby bringing societal harmony, peace, prosperity, and that notion of coexistence. I mean, there's a lot of literature available on the globalization, the internationalization of education, and particularly the business schools. These are some of the highlights which are flashed in front of you. Globalization philosophy is one thing. Globalization of education that particularly employs interstate transfer of knowledge in pluralistic and multicultural domains. Then internationalization of education, and particularly the business education, and the business and trade. I mean, when we talk about the globalization of the business and trade, that means that has to be inserted with the education system as well. Then there have been a number of conferences, number of studies at different levels, focusing on some kind of common platform for the business education, for the business schools to work together. The AACSB is one forum for the membership and accreditation, and development that kind of quality in education, quality in business education as well. Now, the analysis and the conclusion which I have drawn from the literature particularly, and looking at the world of business in totality, that internationalization of business education in developing countries like Pakistan is a fascinating idea, and in all developing countries, it is getting more and more focused. The developing countries' business schools, they are now focusing more on getting membership of international accreditation bodies like AACSB and others. Right. The idea is fundamentally externally focused with respect to students, faculty, employment, and research collaborations. We heard in the first speaker today, also the keynote speaker, he also talked about similar the environments. The challenges include insufficient infrastructure, particularly in the developing countries, business schools, deficient faculty of international stature, majority of marginal students, difficult fit of existing systems with international outlook and financial sources. These are some of the challenges of the developing countries, but there is no other option than what we have to go for, the quality of education, business school, and we have to align ourselves globally for a common platform of the business education, we say. Right, these are some of the stepping forward plans. The world community is looking for university campuses as global meeting places, like we have. Well, this conference basically is our global international meeting place where we all are together, we are interacting with each other, we are sharing new ideas coming from different backgrounds in different countries. These challenges demand broader outlooks for the country management, curriculum, development of international standards, world-class software skills, application of information technology, funding, and all those parameters. In fact, when we sit down together, the people coming from across the world from different backgrounds, and then I'm sure we are going to find out a solution one day. So the point is converting threats into the opportunities through education in collaboration with well-established business schools of the developed countries. Internationalization of business schools for global citizenship through business education, and within that curriculum as a fundamental factor for successfully bringing in global culture in social standards is a point of concern. Now, some of the problems of the business schools, in particularly in the developing countries, which mainly focus on the faculty, development of the faculty, then the some financial deficiencies and the infrastructure insufficiencies. then this accreditation of international body is one point of concern, right, where the most of the developing countries they are focusing on because they want to raise their standard of business education. The parameters set for international accreditation are predominantly those which fall beyond the capacity of business schools belonging to the developing countries at the moment. But they're developing with the passage of time as their GDP is increasing, the awareness about the business education is enhancing with the passage of time. These are some of the main problems which are facing, which are being faced by the business schools of the developing country. Right, this is in fact the model in fact where we can have basically the two main parameters preparing for internationalization and affecting change for internationalization of the business schools in the developing countries. And it basically aims at linking the business schools of the developed countries and developing countries so that they come at a common platform and the common factor for comprehensive success of the business schools in curriculum. And curriculum, we in the paper, in fact, we have concluded that curriculum is the main software which would run the entire mechanism of business education in the developing and developed countries. And finally, the outcome is successful internationalization of business schools for global peace, harmony, and coexistence. So with all these factors in mind, four here, and bringing in a change, bringing in the business schools of developing countries up to the level of the developed countries, this is how we can achieve that kind of coexistence, that notion of peace and prosperity collectively at the global level. Thank you very much. And I'm sure you won't have any questions.
Sir. Thank you for your presentation. Very interesting as we look at professional schools, as you indicated, business schools, law school, medical schools, and how they prepare the leaders for the next world. A question is, how would you help get the philosophy that you're trying to impart on, which I agree with, to get to develop that kind of faculty with that same type of vision and mission in the school, because you'll have to develop then that kind of mission and curriculum that the faculty members adopt to. And secondly, in the American and pretty much I think the European British system in terms of their level of education to go into business school, here is usually to conquer the world, to take advantage of it, to make as much money that you can, to step on the younger guys. So that model, bringing intersectionality of what you're trying to create and bring it with the Western world philosophy, in changing that type of paradigm with the way of thinking, the way you do business, the solution problem, change the world better. You think that there is really an area where certain schools in the U.S. can connect, like at NYU School of Business or Tufts School in Boston, to really kind of work with you guys, where you find that same type of synergy and kind of model that you just expressed?
That's true. In fact, you see what happens is that we cannot, the developing countries, business schools, they cannot ask the business schools of the developed countries to make changes according to their desire.
Right.
The only thing is that we, for example, in Pakistan, we have selected 10 top business schools of the world.
Okay.
And nowadays we are working on that, and basically we are working on the curriculum. We want to get into some kind of alignment with the curriculum of those schools, and we would like to develop our own infrastructure. We would like to come up to that level, minimum level of the business schools of international standard, and where we can have the MOUs, where we can have that kind of understanding, and then one day we will have that kind of quality of education also in mind, and this is how we are developing that. We have MOUs so far signed with 33 business schools of the world. Mm-hmm. And in that, some of the schools, they are already AACSB accredited, they have the membership. So this is how we are going to, this is not a one day, it's a 1 year job. Maybe over a period of time we gain that kind of, because we have a desire to get into that category of better quality of education like we have globally in the world.
Gotcha. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.